It's Tuesday. It is the sixth day of August, and it feels like forever since I've been in the office to give you the full spectrum whiteboard weather. We were on the road last Friday at Chick-fil-A and Robinson, and yesterday I tried to get in a live report from Ohio Pile, but as I suspected, the coverage down there was a little bit sketchy. So, back in the office today, full spectrum weather report, got all your graphics for you, and of course, when we're in the office, we have our whiteboard weather theme song from Good Brother Earl. So let's check it out. All right, and there we have it, the show off and running on a Tuesday. Thanks everyone for tuning in today. If I was reading correctly, I saw some of you said that you wanted to shovel snow. It is not National Margarita Day, so lay off the sauce, man. I don't want to shovel snow, and I don't know many people that do. The good news about heat and humidity is you don't have to shovel it off of your driveway. It is, it's something you can look at from the inside out without any worries. So, in terms of any precipitation in the area right now, looks like it's most widespread. There are a couple of isolated showers. We talked about them this morning, but it's most widespread in Mercer and Venango County. And I think really the rest of the afternoon, the coverage is going to be fairly spotty across the area. We'll talk all about that coming up in just a couple of minutes. First, we want to allow more people to join the conversation, so I want to show you a couple things I haven't shown you for a while. Hey, Phil Spano in the house. How you doing, buddy? Thanks for checking in, my buddy Phil Spano. This is the homepage, PittsburghWeatherNow.com. On it, links to all of our original contents. There's the Wake Up Whiteboard Weather segment from this morning, and the fun fact from this afternoon. This week, I'm talking about world weather records. Also, you scroll down the home page and you have links to all of my sponsors, and I ask that you support them whenever possible. The Moon Golf Club. We also have our Braun Bostich All Weather Wealth Tips. A new one came out yesterday, and this is really good reading. If you're interested in financial advisor advice, this is all free to you. You click on it, and you have a link to all of these informational blogs. The one this week talks about what is a 50-20-30 budget rule. So it's really interesting reading there, and it's all free to you by logging on to PittsburghWeatherNow.com. We also have our Buell Insurance Agency photo gallery, and a little further down, a link to our site sponsor, one of our site sponsors, the Lisa Wilson Real Estate Team, for all of your real estate needs. And they are good folks, and the reason I know this is because my wife is on the Lisa Wilson real estate team. So if you want good, trustworthy real estate agents, Lisa Wilson and Shelly Verzella got you covered. All right, let me cover some birthdays today before we get into the weather information. Born on this day, Lucille Ball was born on this day. Some very notable people. Andy Warhol, born on this day. Remember JonBenet Ramsey? Of course you do. It was a crime story that was in the news for so many years. She was born on this day. I'm not even sure they ever really resolved that case. Movie producer M. Night Shyamalan David Robinson, the Admirable, if you know him from NBA stardom with the San Antonio Spurs. If you're a fan of ESPN, you know who Mike Greenberg is. He has a birthday today. And two notable Pittsburgh people. New to the Pittsburgh Steelers this year, Dante Moncrief, a wide receiver. If you don't know him yet, you probably will before the season is through. I have high hopes for Dante Moncrief. And my buddy, Paul Steigerwald, has a birthday today as well. So Steigy is celebrating today. It's National Root Beer Float Day, National Fresh Breath Day today. So pass out the chewing gum and the Tic Tacs. And it's National Night Out Day today, where we celebrate and promote police and community partnerships and interactions to foster good law enforcement and neighborhood relationship. So it is National Night Out Day today. And there are little celebrations that go on in many communities all across the area. So that's what we got cooking today. Now let's hit up some weather information. I should also make note, sunset tonight is on the early side of 8:30. It is now prior to 8:30, so the daylight hours continue to get shorter and shorter. All right, some current conditions. It is 84. Right now, we have a southwest wind coming in at 10 miles an hour. The dew point temperature is 63 degrees, so it is moderately humid outside. And I think the best threat, the main threat from any showers or thunder showers tonight will be for heavy downpours of rain. Here's the way it looks right now on radar. As I mentioned, you look up in through Mercer and Venango County. That's where we have the most widespread showers right now. There are a couple of cells in other locations. Let me zoom in here a little closer, use my fingers. Newcastle, you're seeing a heavier downpour of rain right now. Also southern parts of Lawrence County. Couple of showers moving through parts of the Cranberry and Wexford area right now. One just moving into Cranberry Township and one just south of Wexford right now, probably closer to McCandless Township. So very spotty coverage locally. You get north of I-80, becomes a little more widespread. And I do think this general setup will be the case as we head between now and about 7 o'clock this evening, with a much better chance to see more numerous showers after 11 o'clock tonight during the overnight time frame. So here's the way the surface map looks right now. You can see we're ahead of a frontal boundary. It's back across northwestern Ohio. We have a southwest flow that's providing moisture for the atmosphere. The triggering mechanism is this front, so that's why the showers are more numerous in northeastern Ohio and northwestern Pennsylvania as you get closer to the actual cold front. Now that cold front will be slow moving, and as it gets closer to us late tonight and tomorrow, that's when the showers will become more numerous as well. This is first thing tomorrow morning, about 7, 8 a.m. The front gets a little bit closer. The moisture feed gets a little bit closer, and so does the instability. So I think showers will become most numerous during the day tomorrow, which means probably all of us can expect to see rain at some point tomorrow, with again the greatest threat being for some heavier downpours of rain. Now as we head toward tomorrow evening, the first front will be moving through the area. That is front number one. So we'll get into a lull in the activity. You can see this area between this front and that front. That's where we'll spend tomorrow night and early on Thursday. Then as we get closer to Thursday afternoon, this is Thursday morning, Thursday afternoon, the secondary front will swing through the area. That will bring with it, behind it, or with it, I should say, a line of some showers and thunder showers Thursday afternoon. And then for you, Daryl Dolan, here comes a 10-18 area of high pressure that will be moving in here starting late Thursday into Friday and the weekend. And along with that will come some very pleasant weather conditions. Show you very quickly, there's your 10-18 high, Daryl. That is Friday afternoon. That drifts into the Midwest, suppresses moisture to the south. We'll have a northerly flow, cooler, drier weather Friday and through the weekend. So if you're planning to go to the Steelers preseason game on Friday night at Heinz Field, the weather conditions look very pleasant and delightful, and it'll stay that way through the weekend. So all that said, let us head to the whiteboard and break it down for you. Your sunrise and sunset times, as I said, sunset tonight now on the early side of 8:30 Average high and low, 82.63. The moon is entering its first quarter phase. Main threat today, tonight, and even when we get some showers on Thursday will be heavy downpours of rain. Again, two fronts in the next 48 hours. First one Wednesday afternoon, the second one Thursday afternoon. And just a little FYI, we've seen our fair share of dry time lately. Three of the last 14 days, we have had measurable rain, which means 11 of the 14 we have not. So it has been more dry than wet in the last 2 weeks. Tonight, a spotty shower before 7 o'clock, and then a lull in the activity tonight, and then showers become likely after 11 o'clock tonight. So overnight tonight while you're sleeping, 66, the low temperature. Tomorrow, humid with scattered showers, maybe even a thunderstorm or two, 79. Again, this is probably the most active day tomorrow, 79. Tomorrow night, things go quiet, 64, but clouds stick around. And then on Thursday, that second front moves through in the afternoon with it. Some thunder showers, otherwise partly sunny, 81. Once the second front comes through, behind it, very comfortable and pleasant. Friday, clouds and sunshine, 78. Saturday, pleasant with sunshine, 78. And Sunday, mostly sunny skies and 80 degrees. So a little unsettled at times between now and Thursday afternoon, but not raining the whole time. And then as we get into Friday and the weekend, things settle down very nicely and set up very nicely for the weekend with some cooler and drier air, low humidity. We're going to see overnight lows Friday, Saturday, and Sunday probably down into the 50s. So you'll get a nice break from your AC over the course of the weekend. As always, I ask you to please share Whiteboard Weather with your Facebook friends. I appreciate it. Continue to send in your photos as we continue to add to our photo gallery. You can send them to pittsburghweathernow@gmail.com, and you can order your very own Whiteboard Weather merchandise by visiting the homepage, and there's a link right at the top of the homepage. As always, please visit the site, support my sponsors. Without them, some of this, probably a lot of this, would not be possible because, well, quite honestly, I need to pay some bills. So support them whenever possible. It is much appreciated. Final little note of today, if you're suffering from some allergies, it's ragweed that's got you down. Ragweeds today are in a moderate range. That is going to wrap it up for today. As always, I appreciate your time. Thanks for tuning in. I will talk to you again first thing tomorrow morning, 7 a.m. for Wake Up Whiteboard Weather, which is sponsored by WetGo. Have yourself a great rest of this Tuesday. Peace.